Yo, what's up? It's Stacy Cunningham, Program Director of 106 KMEL, and you are hanging with Sean Kennedy with Ill Trendz TV.
Miami, the Playboy's paradise. Pretty girls, fast cars. That's just a facade. The bridge separates South Beach from my Miami. The real Miami. This is where we hustle.
Every day I'm hustling. 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 Every day I'm hustling.
Who you suckers think you're tripping with? Yes, I'm the boss. 745, white on white, that's Rick Ross. I keep them wide, I keep them long, I keep them fat. I keep them coming back, we keep them coming back. I'm in the distribution, I'm like Atlantic. I got them pretty things flying across the Atlantic. I know Pablo Noriega, the real Noriega. He owe me 100 favors. I ain't petty player, we buy the whole thing. See, most of my homies hustle, they still do their thing. My roof back, my money ride. I'm on the pedal, show you what I'm running like. When they snatch black, I cry for.
Yo, what's going on? It's your man, Sean Kennedy. We chilling right here at KMEL with the program director, Stacy Cunningham. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
That's good. Thank you for letting us come chill with you today.
No problem.
As you know, we have a segment in our show where we cover business people in the San Francisco area, and this is covering Black businesswoman this week. And,
that's me.
That's you. And we want to talk to you about, you know, what it takes to run the number one hip-hop urban station in the number four market. We want to talk to you about what it took to get that far and where you came from and all that good stuff.
Okay.
All right. So we're going to be right back at you guys in just a second. Like I said, it's your man, Sean Kennedy, chilling right here, 106.1 KMEL, with program director, Stacy Cunningham.
So it's either all or nothing.
I'm all in.
S-O, hey, F to the A-B, hey, Black Butterfly. Let's go. And I'm a bad boy like Martin and Will. Show you what you've been missing, like the kids on a carton of milk. Hey, I can snatch something bad out of the hood. Hey, and bring them back to the pad out by the woods. Hey, you know the coupe bring the bad out of the good. And I'm usually not laying in the bougie spots. Girl, we could blow quicker than Uzi shots. Chill with a crystal's cold, the koozie's hot, you feel?
I ain't really the kind of girl that would say that I'm a bad girl. Though I should, so many times I did what I thought.
Back again, chilling right here, 106.1 KMEL, Stacy Cunningham, program director. So, Stacy, what is it like, being ahead of the number one station in San Francisco Bay Area?
I mean, I can't complain. It's a blessing. I get to do what I like to do and what I love to do, okay. And that's to be involved with the music business. That's to be involved with all aspects of a great radio station, a heritage radio station. So, I'm very, very lucky. Lucky woman.
Right. Now, let's talk about where you got your start. You know, we know that you came from Southern California.
Mm-hmm.
Let's sort of talk about that for a minute. Where did you start, and how did you get into radio?
I started at a radio station called 92.3 The Beat.
Okay.
It's in L.A. I started as an intern, street team, worked my way up, slept in the van sometime, did 5 a.m. calls. Eventually became promotions assistant, assistant promotions director in the office, worked my way up from there.
Now let me stop you right there. When you were on the street team, did you see yourself as a assistant promotions director?
I did. I saw myself as promotions director.
Okay.
That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to do marketing. I wanted to do promotions. I loved every aspect of marketing a radio station and what went into it, and I really had a love for it. So that's what I dreamt, and that's what I wanted to do.
When you were back in Los Angeles and you were on the street team, working your way up to be a work in the promotions department, what are some of the things that you had to do to get to that goal?
Work hard. I learned early on to learn every aspect of the radio station because you never know where you're going to land. I learned traffic. I learned working the boards. I learned working accounting. I learned community work. I learned what the salespeople did. I learned everything about a radio station that I possibly could, so that way if there was a door that opened up, I could kind of slide right in, regardless of promotions or not. That way I could always have a foot in the door in case something bigger opened up.
Okay. Well, look, we're gonna slide out for a second, get into a couple of videos. We're going to come back. We're going to finish talking to Stacy right here at 106.1 KMEL. It's your man, Sean Kennedy. We'll be right back at you.
Searching for the right, but it keeps avoiding me. Sorrow in my soul, cause it seems that wrong really loves my company. He's more than a man, and this is more than love, the reason that the sky is blue. The clouds are rolling in, because I'm gone again, and to him I just can't be true. And I know that he knows I'm a
We back again with Stacy Cunningham at 106.1 KMEL. So you worked your way up the ladder.
Yes.
You then came from Los Angeles. You landed in the Bay Area running. You took the assistant promotions job. And next thing you know, program director position's open.
Yes.
And yes. You jumped right in the door.
I jumped right on in.
How did that happen?
Easy. No.
Easy. You hear that? She's making it sound so easy.
You know, when I was in promotions, I never thought of myself as just doing promotions. I really cared for this station.
Okay.
And I tried to have an input on every piece of this radio station, even though I wasn't in program at the time. If there was a hot song, I would try and give my 2 cents, even though it probably wasn't my business at the time.
Right.
I put in my 2 cents. And I really had tried to look at the big picture of the station as opposed to just looking at what my department does. So I think when the job became open, even though I didn't have any programming experience, they looked at me and was like, well, maybe she can handle it because it looks like she's handling the big picture so far.
Now, making a transition from promotions to programming, even with no programming experience, do you get any sort of programming experience from the promotions job? Does that sort of teach you anything about programming?
It's all about what you decide to take out of it. Okay. You know, you can come in and just do your job, what you do every day, but you have to take the initiative to learn. I would go sit in Vaughn's office and talk about music, or look at him do selector, or try and figure out why we played this song at this time and why we played this song this many times, and I would just ask. And so my curiosity led to me learning more about programming, even though I had no programming experience.
The Hyphy Movement in the Bay Area.
Yes.